How's it going, everyone? The goal of this tutorial is to show you how to implement a simple look pointing or first-person aim offset system in Unreal Engine 4, examples of which can be seen in games like Destiny or Halo. The overall idea of the system is to provide an extra, often overlooked level of interaction with the character that the player is inhabiting, specifically in regards to the seemingly mundane input of just looking around the game world or aiming a weapon. As a quick disclaimer, setup of this system relies on the assumption that you already have a basic familiarity of Unreal Engine 4 and Blueprint, as well as some experience animating in an external program like Blender or Maya. There are plenty of other people on this platform that would do a much better job of expanding on those topics if you're interested. If I had to name drop a couple that have really helped me out, it would be Mattew Wadstein for high-level explanations of UE4 fundamentals, and underscore productions for more FPS-specific information. Links to both of those channels will be in the description. Also, I'm still relatively new to the more technical side of game development, and the techniques shown in this video aren't necessarily reflective of best practices for working in UE4. This is just what I found makes the most sense to me, and hopefully to you as well. With that all out of the way, let's get to it. I've zipped up all the animations seen in this project and included a link to them, as well as a couple other resources, in the description below. Big shout out to Jax on itch.io for providing some cool low-poly guns to mess around with. For this tutorial, we'll be using a modified and rigged version of his scar from that model pack. When designing aim offsets for first person, you generally want to have a few different versions depending on the player's current state of movement. This includes standing idle, walking movement, and air movement, aim down sight movement, etc. For the purposes of this tutorial and for the sake of simplicity, we'll just stick with the first two for now. Once you have your first person arms rigged and posed in their base state, you're going to position the dominant hand so that the weapon is pointing away from center screen in the four cardinal directions, up, down, left, and right. For standing still, we'll keep those poses tighter and less exaggerated, and for movement, we'll really push in those same directions while adding some roll to the horizontal tilting. You can go back and add an additional four poses for each state in diagonal directions for smoother rotational movement. But again, for the sake of keeping this video short and sweet, I'm going to omit those. The same principles apply though. As a quick side note, before moving ahead, you're going to want to set up a blank first-person example project and replace the animations in the locomotion state machine with the ones I provided in the link below. Since my animations are designed to be positive X forward, you may need to rotate your FP arms mesh in the character BP to properly align with the camera again. For my version of the project, I've created a separate BP for the scar that acts as a child to the first-person character, but if you're just following along, you really only need to attach a skeletal mesh to the hand socket. Some adjustment of the socket's rotation or position may be needed to get the weapon to sit in the character's hands properly. After exporting those look-pointing poses to individual FBX files, we're going to drag them right into your first-person example project. Select the pre-existing mannequin arm skeleton, and import all. You would think that we would dump these into a couple of aim offset classes, but I've opted to use two separate blend spaces instead, as I found them to work out much better for the effect that I was after. We're going to create one for standing idle, and another for ground movement. Starting with standing, drag the idle underscore loop animation to the center of the blend space, and drag each of the look pointing poses to the four directions we've covered so far, right, left, up, and down. Due to the default inputs for looking up and down producing an inverted axis value, I put my up pose on the bottom and my down pose on the top. Then on the left, change the horizontal axis name to read mouse X, the min value to negative 1.1, the max to 1.1, and the interpolation time to 0.5. Repeat this for the vertical axis, substituting mouse Y for mouse X. Play around with these values at your own discretion. They will impact how extreme the poses appear, as well as the speed they are switched between respectively. To preview what you've created so far, hold shift and move your mouse across the gridded area. Although you can't see it from first person just yet, it should give you a good idea of the interpolation speed and help double check for any misplaced poses. Back in the content browser, let's duplicate the blend space we just made and add an underscore run to the end to help differentiate. Opening it up, we're going to replace the base pose with run underscore loop, as well as the idle directional poses with their running counterparts. Back on the left side, we're going to change the interpolation speed for mouse X and mouse Y to 0.35. This will speed it up a little bit. and we're going to increase or decrease the maxes and mins to 1.5 and negative 1.5 respectively. Hold shift over the grid to double check your work, and most of the setup is done at this point. Next, we'll have to jump over to the first person character BP and give it a way to communicate the mouse's axis values to the animation BP. Create two float variables, one for mouse X and one for mouse Y, and set them using their corresponding axis value. You could update these on tick, but in the interest of providing at least one piece of good practice, we'll use a timer connected to a custom event instead to keep as much off of tick as possible. Start the timer on begin play, set it to loop every 0.1 seconds, and if you like, you can hook them up to a couple print screen nodes to make sure it's all firing correctly. Another thing we can quickly do is set up a spring arm as the root of the arms mesh. This allows us to tick on a bool called enable camera lag that provides a greater feeling of weight to the character's mesh. Below it, you'll see a number called camera lag speed. Lower values are sluggish and heavier feeling, while higher values only add a slight weighty effect. In this instance, I've set my default to 75. You can easily jump and play an editor to see the effect right away, and adjust your values as you see fit. Lastly, move to the animation BP to set up the blend between our base locomotion state machine and the look pointing blend spaces. Start on the event graph and pure cast to the first person character BP to be able to grab its mouse X and mouse Y values. Drag out from those values and promote them to variables, and make sure they're getting updated. Switch to the anim graph and grab both blend spaces from the asset browser on the right. Connect them to a blend poses by bool node. I left my blend times at the default 0.1 second, but again, feel free to change these values if it feels better to you. Take the isMoving boolean, which should come standard with the first person animation BP, and plug it into the active value slot. Plug the local mouse input variables we just made into the respective slots on the blend spaces. Now create a standard blend node to layer the look pointing on top of the locomotion state machine. I set its alpha to 0.35, but this is another value you can mess around with. And with that, you're pretty much finished. As you can see, we progressively enhance the subtle movements of your character to become more responsive and tactile as you both move and look around the game world. I hope I could help you out through this tutorial, and if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, feel free to leave it in the comments section below. If you'd like to see more quick tutorials in UE4, in the first-person animation department, or just UE4 in general, please let me know and I'll do my best to accommodate you guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all later.